About borrowing my bike, okay?
Boy and a girl, teenagers.
Because you're a cretin.
Yeah, well,
that's
no one's
why.
More amazed
why
than I am.
Too hard to go down and get my tire fixed.
No, you don't seem to understand, David. Last time you borrowed my bike, you put the seat up.
I'd like to, but tonight's impossible.
Don't you treat myself like that? Forget it, okay?
Fine, I'll get your seat back this time.
Please.
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
Come on.
I promise.
Come on.
Fine, then you can't borrow my box.
Hey, get out of
no,
here!
No,
you're a creep.
You're a creep. You grow up.
Mom!
You can't borrow it ever again.
Okay. Now, about that drill brake, there won't be any slippage on the grip.
Absolutely not.
Good, good. Then let's see the design.
Yes.
The drill brake?
Yes.
It's on its way.
Mm. Now, I like the green for this. What do you think?
Hi.
Oh, here she is now.
I'm sorry. The babysitter missed her bus. Jim was getting diapers. It was one thing after the other. We're increasing Ruthie's solids, and, I have a little girl at home. I mean, she had gas all night, and we tried everything. A hot water bottle, heating pads, everything. But she cried all the way through Letterman. Oh. Design number one. Design two.
It up.
And Brother Jack's here.
Tell him to come on in. What are you doing down here?
Nice to see you too. I'm job hunting again.
Any luck?
Want to grab some lunch?
I can't. I've got a meeting. Guess who called me this morning? Brian McGinn.
Who?
Brian McGinn, freshman year, University of Washington.
No boyfriend?
That's the one.
What do you want?
I guess he's in town on business.
Yeah, I remember him. He ruined my spring vacation. He did. We were all supposed to go up to Pine Lake, the whole family, remember? But no, couldn't go. Why? Because you were freaking out.
What are you talking about?
Come on. You were a mess. The guy dumped you.
I was not a mess, and he did not dump me.
He did, too. He dumped you for your best friend, Margie. Margie...
Court.
Margie Court, right. There you go. You locked yourself in your room. You wouldn't come out. You wouldn't eat. You wouldn't do anything. Hell, Mom thought you were going to kill yourself.
That's ridiculous.
He was studying some, weird, bizarre...
Ancient Chinese. What a fabulous memory you have.
So, what's old Brian up to now?
I don't know. He lives in Chicago. He's a commodities broker, all right?
And when are you seeing him?
I'm not.
Now, aren't you just a little bit curious?
Not particularly.
Huh? What if he's rich and lonely and likes to be tied up and all that stuff? Hmm?
Goodbye, Jack.
Bye.
What do you mean, a rash?
Well, what did the doctor say?
An allergy to what?
Really? Well, all she had was rice, cereal, yogurt. You think it was the turkey? Well, listen, tell Blanca not to give her the yogurt tonight for dinner. No, Jim, if we take away two things, then we won't know what caused it. Look, I gotta go. I love you too. Bye. Just a little pop with Brucey, no biggie.
Yeah, I need the Gershenson contract.
Okay. 1 second. Go. Here we go. Oh. Oh, better.
Southern exposure, custom made for people with green thumbs.
I love the living room.
Well, the carpet's awfully worn.
Well, the floors are hardwood.
And of course, you're not buying a carpet.
Would you excuse us for a minute?
Honey, how are we doing?
I don't know. Listen, thank you for letting me tag along.
It's my pleasure.
And I want to apologize to you for not having those specs ready when you asked.
Oh, please don't worry about it. Junior husband, have a nice weekend.
Yeah, thank you. We had a great time.
Take a deep breath. Relax.
I want them to buy a house. I want to sell something. I want to sell something so
you
badly.
You will. You're a natural seller.
Yeah.
We'd like to make an offer on the house. But we really don't want to go over 120.
I understand. You two are really so perfect for this house. But there was an offer of 125.
Is it a firm offer?
I'm afraid so.
When did this happen?
We got the call driving here.
Do you think they qualify?
Cindy.
What?
Look, there are lots of other houses. If this one isn't exactly right...
Ted.
All right, all right. Look, do you think 127.5 will do it?
I think so, Ted. Let me check with the office, okay?
Yeah, this is Joanne Layton. We're out at the...
Annie!
Brian?
Hi.
I didn't see you.
Glad you could make it. You look great.
Thank you. You too. Actually, you look different. I remember a big guy.
What can I get you?
Could I have a glass of white wine, please?
I'm fine, thanks.
So, I didn't know if I would recognize you.
You haven't changed a bit.
Thanks. I think... You like Chicago?
Yeah, it's fine. It's a little cold in the wintertime, but I like it.
You're a commodities bro.
Uh-huh.
How did you get into that?
Father-in-law. Ex-father-in-law. He took me to the exchange one morning, and that was it. Probably seen it on TV, guys yelling and screaming, waving their arms in the air.
So you didn't marry Margie?
No, we broke up about a year after we got together.
What happened to Margie?
She married a lawyer. They're divorced.
Good.
I didn't really mean that. Thank you.
You're not married.
Divorced twice. Two kids. I guess I told you that. Do you have kids?
No, unfortunately.
So what brings you to Seattle?
I decided to take a year off and travel around the country and look up old friends.
A year? Lucky you.
Yeah, well, so what are you up to?
I'm in advertising. I just got promoted to account executive.
Terrific.
You sound surprised.
No. No, it's just I never really thought of you in that kind of a... I don't know, just...
What did you think?
I don't know.
Do you still have that tooth? You used to call it the porcelain wonder.
Porcelain beauty.
Porcelain beauty. I seem to recall a dead concert we went to. You dropped it in a bottle of slow gin. We had to drink the whole bottle to get the tooth.
Don't remind me. Oh.
You threw up all over the blanket.
You threw up, and then you passed out on me.
Passed out.
I drove home.
Get out of here.
Yes, I did, and you kept going, oh, you're going too fast, you're going too fast, you know, and you lit a match, and of course you had no dash lights, and it read 20 miles an hour. We were crawling. Yes, we were. I still go to dead concerts.
When people ask me what I do for a living...
No, thanks.
I don't see how you can sell something that doesn't exist.
Well, it will exist. That's why they call them futures.
Thousands of students marching on the White House?
Mm-hmm. That's like selling real estate on Mars, because someday people may live there.
Yeah, sort of.
I can't see how people would be stupid enough to buy it.
Matter of supply and demand.
Suppose a supplier knows he's going to have a demand for pork bellies.
Pork bellies?
Bacon.
Sick.
That's disgusting.
Well, it could be oranges or wheat, whatever. It doesn't make any difference. To make sure he's got enough. He buys now at a certain price, and then if the price goes up or down, either the buyer or the seller makes out like a bandit.
Sort of legalized gambling.
You get it?
Yeah, sort of.
I don't.
Still can't believe that Grandpa let you go to Washington by yourself.
What was this red stuff?
Not by myself. Ridiculous. It's very expensive. Eat it.
So what happened?
There were six of us. We lived all together in this big house in Roosevelt Way. Me, Brian, David Leach, Lance Luria. Whatever happened to Lance Luria?
He's a doctor in upstate New York.
Really? And Leach?
Working for the Department of Justice.
Oh, unbelievable. Everybody called Leach the Will Rogers of drugs.
Why?
They never met a drug he didn't like.
And Jay Stuntzy, he was just as bad. I mean, what's he up to these days?
He died in a car accident.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess you never kept in touch, huh?
No. There were six of us. We piled into Leach's car, this big red Impala. Guys in the front, chicks in the back, me, Margie Court, Roberta Reed, Luria's girlfriend, and...
But you got there.
Oh, we got there all right, but not in Leach's car.
Why? What happened?
This one. He couldn't stop arguing with Leach over who was the fastest guitar, Alvin Lee or Jimi Hendrix.
Who's Alvin Lee?
And then just outside of St. Louis... He tells me to get out of the car. We hitchhiked the rest of the way.
Rude.
You hitchhiked?
Just from St. Louis. Would anyone like some coffee?
Me, please.
Well, you know, you never let us hitchhike, Mom.
No, I don't. It was a stupid thing. We're lucky to be alive.
So who's Alvin Lee?
Yeah.
10 years after.
Who drank the milk without saying anything?
He did.
I'm gonna go to the store and get some more. I'll be just a minute.
10 years after what?
I'll come with you, Annie.
Annie?
10 years after what?
Annie?
After what?
Thanks. We'll get some ice cream just in case. Chocolate chip. You still a chocolate junkie? Or was that just when you got stoned? Okay, you've had a religious conversion. You don't get stoned anymore. You don't eat chocolate anymore?
How come you never kept in touch with anybody?
I don't know. I just didn't.
I understand about Margie, but Jay and Lance and Roberta? I was the guy on the outside. You guys were close.
At the time, I didn't feel much like seeing anybody. I knew everybody felt sorry for me, and that was a hard thing for me to deal with. You know, you lose touch.
Is that why you transferred? Because of me and you?
Oh, no, I was never that crazy about UW. I wanted a smaller campus.
What happened between me and Margie, you know, was never... I mean, it just happened. It's funny, after all these years, I still feel bad about it.
All that happened a long time ago. Everybody has to go through a thing like that. I'm glad you called.
You know what it's like when you walk through that door? It's like you bring the whole world in with you. Sun, trees, the complexities of the marketplace. Listen, I want to tell you what happened to me today. I was taking a nap, and I woke up, and... You're not listening. No, you're not. Oh, you can listen and open mail at the same time? All right. Fine. Anyway, I don't know why I woke up. Maybe the phone rang or it was a washing machine. But I, Oh, now, Lindley? You have to go to the bathroom now?
You didn't shave your legs.
Well, you don't shave on weekends.
So scratchy.
Let me ask you something. When you're at work selling, how do you sell what you sell?
You make a presentation.
Right. You describe the product, then what?
Well, assuming there's interest, it's just a question of price. Basically, you wait for the guy to say yes or no.
And who makes the first presentation?
The old man. I mean, he's still the one who generally sets up the deal.
Is he honest about it?
What do you mean?
Well, is he honest when he describes the thing to the buyer?
Well, yeah. You know, yeah, I mean, he presents it in the best possible light. Yeah, sure, he's honest.
Just thinking of it. Ugh.
What?
Today, when I was out with Joanne, she lied about there being another offer on this house, and the couple bought it.
Well, that's not exactly lying.
No.
No, it's business.
You're right.
No, it is. I mean, she didn't make them buy the house. She just made them want to. Right? Right?
Right. No, I don't know, Sam.
What?
It's everything. It's the way you sell. It's the jewelry and the clothes and the car. I mean, I had to give Joanne a ride in my car the other day, and I felt like a fool. I mean, she laughs at my car, at my clothes, everything. I mean, don't get me wrong, I think that she really likes me. It's just... I just don't get it.
What does she drive?
She drives a Mercedes. What else?
There's nothing wrong with that, is there?
Things I promised you. Nightshirt, blankets, pajamas.
Oh, Mrs. Eisenberg, this is great.
Oh, no, wait. Wait, you have to see this. Isn't this precious?
Oh, it's adorable. Thank you.
Now, yellow will go with a boy or a girl. Let me look at you. Oh, you're huge.
3 weeks to go. Friday's my last day.
Do you know what it's going to be?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're carrying pretty low, so it'll probably be a boy. Of course, that's what they told me, and I was humongous. I can't believe Ruthie ever wore this.
It's funny. What is she, 5-6 months now?
Almost 7 and a half.
Oh, getting to be a big girl.
Yeah.
Are you sure you want to give these away?
Oh, yeah, I can't use these anymore.
What if you have another baby?
Me? I can hardly handle one.
Two Trains is not on Dixie Chicken.
Yes, it is.
I remember distinctly because Sailing Shoes is on the first Neon Park cover.
No way.
The Cake on the Swing, come on.
That was before. Come on, come on. Kenny Gradney was on bass, and Bill Payne and Sam Clayton. And Roy Estrada was already gone because he went to Captain Beefheart.
I know that. And Bonnie Raitt singing backup.
Right, Dixie Chicken.
Well, maybe Fates Don't Fail Me Now, but not Dixie Chicken.
No way.
What?
Just come with me. I got an idea here. Oh. No, just check this record store out here. See this?
Oh,
come on, come on, come on. What? I want you to wait right here. Cut one, please. Oh, look at that. Two Trains. Dixie Chicken.
Yeah. Very good. Ha ha.
Think you are at home.
I realize this may not be the right time to ask what I'm about to ask. Thing is, I'd like a raise.
Your salary review doesn't come up for 6 months.
I know. It's just that I could use it now.
Why?
Well, I'd like to buy Kay a new car.
What's wrong with the car?
Nothing. It's just not right for what she's doing.
Well, she's selling houses.
And it's just not the right style for that. It's just not the right car to be driving clients around in when you're trying to sell them on something as big as a house.
What does she say?
I wanted to surprise her. I really think this is important.
We have a deal with Morton Chrysler. See what you can get for a couple hundred a month. It'll go against your raise.
Thanks. Really. But that's not going to do it. I wanted to get her something foreign.
You're telling me she can't sell houses and an American car?
Look, Dad, I know you don't understand, but I really feel this is important for her. My raise is only 6 months away anyway.
That's right, it is.
Meaning?
You talk it over with her.
Dad, she feels like she's not making it. Like she's an outsider.
Take a ride down to Morton's, or wait 6 months.
Nail polish before?
Not on you.
Oh, it looks cold to me.
Are you backing out?
Somebody could see us.
So? Let him.
Oh.
Lay. Come on.
God! Oh, God!
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi. I forgot the Schubert proposal. What?
Come on, honey. Show her. Tell her.
She crawled. You're kidding.
She crawled.
She crawled? See? Ay, venga. My baby crawled? You crawled?
All the way from there to there.
Venga. Venga, Blanca. She wasn't creeping? She got off her belly?
Oh, completely, yeah, honey. I mean, hands, knees, you should have seen her. It was incredible, incredible coordination. Venga. Blanca was dusting the piano, and I came in, and boom, right at me, huh? Come on, honey. Come on, sweetheart. Come on, sweetheart. Show mommy that crawly-wally stuff.
Venga. Venga.
Come on, you little schmunch butt. Show mommy that crawly-wally stuff.
Come on, honey.
Come on, honey.
Come here.
Come on.
Come here, honey. See, si. Can you come to mommy?
See.
Si. Oh. Oh. Come here, sweetheart. Okay. Oh, she's soaking wet.
Yo la cambio, señora.
No.
Yo la cambio, señora. Yo la cambio. No se preocupe.
Ya, mi vida, ya. ¿Qué le pasa?
Something, huh?
Yeah.
Ay, mi linda, véngase con Blanca. Yo te quiero.
That's karma.
Karma?
Well, it's sort of like fate.
Except that what you put out,
you get back.
So you don't have to be a good person to have good karma.
What do you mean?
Well, it can be a terrible person inside and do good things, and you'll have good karma, which means that a bad person can have good karma, or a good person can have bad karma.
Yeah, I guess. Unless we consider their previous lives.
Oh, God.
What?
When you and Margie moved out, David Leitch said that I must really have terrible karma with men.
He was trying to be philosophical, but the way he said it, it was like it was so obvious. And years later, when I was getting divorced from my first husband,
and even with Glenn, standing outside the courthouse, I remembered what Leitch said. And to think that is just something that goes on and on and on. It's too depressing.
Leitch was wrong.
Yeah. It's funny, the things you remember.
Lindley? Lindley? Honey? Honey, what's the matter? Huh?
Ruth crawled.
Well, that's not why you're crying, though.
She crawled for Blanca. She didn't crawl for me. Oh. Blanca's not even her mother. I'm her mother. If she's gonna crawl for anyone, she should crawl for me. I know it's not an earth-shattering event, but it's something, right? I mean, a child only crawls for the first time in its life once, right?
Right.
And
right.
You know where I was? I was at the printers with the rate card. The printers.
Wow.
And then Jim is wearing this diaper, and he's trying to tell me something, and I can't stop opening the mail.
Lindley, what?
Daddy, just go, okay? I'm gonna be fine. Just go.
But
Daddy,
what?
just go.
But Lindley, why was Jim wearing a diaper?
Daddy.
Oh, all right, all right, honey. All right, all right.
Here you go.
Mm.
Hot chocolate.
Mm. Thanks.
Mm.
My hair's still a little wet. Do you have a hair dryer in that thing?
All the amenities of home, except the hair dryer. Oh, Lake Michigan is like an ocean. You can't see to the other side. Now this. This is a lake, Annie. What?
I'm not Annie.
Okay. Who are you?
I'm Ann. I've always been Ann. You're the only one who ever called me Annie. When I was in second grade, my teacher, Miss Valengas, called me Annie, and I stood up and I said, my name is Ann. Ann Gardner. I don't really remember that, but my mother swore it was true.
You should have said something.
Probably.
So why didn't you?
I don't know. I guess I let you call me Annie because I knew you liked calling me Annie. Actually, it's more than that. I think I knew that what you wanted was an Annie, not an Ann. Somebody who baked bread, who made lentil soup and nasturtiums in their salad. So I did all those things. I baked bread, I strung beads, I wore those horrible paisley skirts.
You must have hated me.
No, I didn't hate you.
I loved you. I thought I could make you love me. I never understood why you didn't love me, why you were so stupid.
So you were always so intense. You made me deal with myself in ways I wasn't prepared. See, that was the thing about Margie. Everything was easy. No hassles. Nothing mattered.
Do you realize how young we were?
I do now.
It's all yours.
Oh, man.
Why?
Why? Because I'm a great guy, and I love you.
When I grow up, I'm going to marry you.
This is incredible.
No way.
Get in.
Oh, my gosh. Look at this.
Sam, I don't need this car.
Sure you do.
Come on, get in, Sonny.
You're going to blow Joanne away.
Can I get in?
Sure.
Look at that dash.
Well, come on. What are you waiting for?
Hey, if she doesn't want it, I'll take it.
Sam,
just get in. It's not gonna bite you.
I'm sure, isn't it real leather?
Check out this Beamer, Joe. It's hot.
Oh, wait, get out of there.
It's a great radio.
Oh, Sam, no. This must have cost a fortune.
It's an investment.
No, it's not.
In you.
Look at that radio.
It's excellent. Come on. Get in.
Oh, my gosh.
You're gonna love this car, Kate.
Oh, honey, you look great. You really do.
Well, come on, start it up. Let's take it for a ride.
Turn on the radio.
Thank you.
Oh, well, listen to that thing.
Do you love it?
Oh, this is great. We paid the cable bill twice last month. Picture comes in fuzzy, and we paid double.
How would you feel if I quit my job?
You want to stop work?
I want to come home. Do you think that would be all right?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
A lot less money would be coming in.
I think that would be okay.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
But you think it would be okay? I mean, what do you think about it?
Oh, you mean about having my wife at home, the mother of my child? What, is that the wrong answer?
I'm scared.
Scared of what?
All my life, I've worked for a living. People listen to me out there. I'm responsible. I make decisions. I'm productive. But it's not the same anymore. When I'm at work, I can't help thinking about Ruthie. Maybe it's guilt, but I can't stop thinking about her. wondering if she's happy or sad or...
Honey, come here.
I can't help it. I want to be with her. Is it just me, or do all mothers feel this way? Because if they do, I gotta tell you, I swear it stinks. Lindley Eisenberg, one giant step back for women's lib. What will I do all day? Who will I be?
You'll be you. Only you'll be you here.
Maybe. Maybe not. This is your last chance to back out.
Okay, I back out.
Jim.
Sweetheart, sweetheart, I'm joking. Joking. Remember jokes? You know, actually, there's a lot of things I can think of that'll be nice about having you home. But only under one condition.
What's that?
I tell Joe.
Mm-hmm.
And you tell Blanca.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Dad and the kids, they went to the movies, and I thought I'd take advantage of the quiet and read. Can I get you something to drink?
No, thanks. I'm leaving.
Oh. Where are you going?
Montana. Gonna see a friend.
Well, I'm glad you came to see me. And if I'm ever in Chicago,
There's something you should know. I have AIDS. I guess I slept with the wrong person.
Oh, God.
See, I'm just looking up old friends, trying to set things straight. Sort of saying goodbye. I'm telling you this because this time I want to do it right. You can't make old friends.
Movie?
No, it was dull. Joe slept through the whole thing.
That figures.
Yeah. How come you're not with Brian tonight?
He left. He went to Montana.
Oh. Man, never anything to eat in this place. You know something? I really like that guy.
Me too.
Yeah, I could tell. Could tell he likes you too.
You could?
Yeah. Maybe next summer we can take a trip to Chicago, you know? Visit him?
Maybe.
You know something, Mom? He's the right kind of guy for you. I mean that. I think he is.
I've seen the bright lights of Memphis.
me.